Hey, I'll show you how to create one of these images, or with this quick guide, you'll be able to paint any pictures you desire. I've divided the video into three parts: connecting to the service, setting up your own environment, and finally, examples of painting using AI. If you're not interested in something or can't wait to get to the actual painting, you can easily jump over individual sections. We'll be painting using Midjourney. It's a bot that we'll be communicating with through the Discord service. In the browser, enter the web address, midjourney.com. Select Sign In. Next, click Register. Create an account on Discord. Here's a notice that an external application, in our case, the Midjourney bot, wants access to our Discord account. Of course, that's exactly what we want. Click the link to join the Discord and to creating. And now we're logged into Discord, where we also have Midjourney. We can use Discord in the browser or download the app. The interface is the same in both environments. I will be working with Discord in the browser. When we look in the newbies 161 room, we can see the work of others. Similarly, in the newbies 191 room, we can see various creations. Here we can start creating right away, but doing something directly here is terribly confusing, at least for me. Many people are working here, and their creations mix with ours. That's why I'll show you a trick on how to create your own server in Discord and connect the Midjourney bot to it. Then we'll be able to paint entirely by ourselves. In the left sidebar, click the plus button to add a server. Choose Create My Own. For me and my friends, choose a name for our server and create it. Then, go back to the Midjourney tab. We're in the top right corner, click the character icon named Show Member List to open the right sidebar. Here, click on the Midjourney bot. Continue with Add to Server. Select the server we created earlier. In my case, it's AI Tech Explorers. Now switch to our own server. We've successfully finished clicking, and now we can finally dive into the actual painting. To paint, we use the Imagine command, which we type after a slash in the message line. Then, enter what we want to paint. Let's start with a landscape, for example. How about having Midjourney paint a mountain landscape with a lake as our first image? Wait for it to be created. And here we have it. Midjourney always creates four variations for us. When we click on the image, it enlarges. If we want to choose a specific one, we can select U1, U2, U3, and U4. I like the fourth one the most, so I choose U4. We can further enlarge the image by opening it in the browser, and here we can simply save the image to our computer. So, isn't it quite simple to paint using AI? And if you like the video, I'd be happy if you support it with a thumbs up. I have prepared two more painting examples for you. Again, we'll write a slash followed by imagine. I'm adding a white background to my request and appending the AR parameter at the end, which defines the aspect ratio. The painted picture features some real babe-like female robots, and the images are vertically oriented. While painting, we can also choose the technique Midjourney will use to paint or draw the image. For the last example, I'll have it sketch a BMW X5 in a 16:9 format. I'll enlarge the third image. And open it in the browser. Here's a public link to our artwork, which we can share, for example, to show off to friends what we've painted. I'm curious about what you've created, and I'd be happy if you leave a link to your created images in the comments, or let me know what you think about painting using AI. That's all for today. Enjoy your time, and I'm looking forward to next time.